All right, welcome back to Problem Solver Politics. I'm your host, Cardinalis, with Cody the Oracle.
Hey, everybody.
And we got a very interesting article that we want to dissect right now. There is a statistic, a very specific statistic, a net statistic, that supposedly, according to Business Insider, proves that Andrew Yang is, quote, the ideal running mate in the Democratic primary. Now, that's quite a vigorous and audacious claim to make about Andrew Yang. So we thought we might dive right in. Cody, tell us what Business Insider is talking about.
Before we get right into it, I just want to bring up one thing. Is we actually, interestingly enough, we did a video talking about this same data point just a couple days ago. However, we took a different perspective on it. And this, the reason we wanted to talk about this, and I'll show you guys one second, I think the reason that stands out is something I think for both of us is the idea that, admittedly, most probably is a blind spot for us this time. A couple times thought about it, but we'd always just thought of Andrew Yang as president. We were thinking, if Tulsi and Yang were to run, it'd make more sense for her to be president and stuff. But Business Insider runs an article and says, one statistic shows why Andrew Yang is an ideal running mate in the Democratic primary. To be frank, I never thought about the idea of what if he was someone's running mate. Every now and then, like on stream, people would ask, and I think, and I look at it, like, I think if Biden wins, I have said in the past, I think Biden might take on Yang as a running mate. But they say
But we never addressed it except for in kind of like a whimsical brush it off, isn't that cute kind of way.
Oh, yeah. Or it's just like, I guess if I had to think about it, right? Never really put much thought into it. But Insider brings up a good point. Now, the data point we're talking about, we'll show right here, and this is the one we talked about the other day as well, says, out of the 268 undecided voters who knew of Yang, 46% would be satisfied with him as the nominee, and 24% would not be satisfied, giving him positive net support of 22 percentage points among general election voters who know him and have not yet decided whether to vote Democrat or Republican.
Can I interject one thing to just kind of frame this argument a little bit and why these stats matter? Is Barack Obama said his best political decision of his entire political career was choosing his VP, was choosing Joe Biden as his vice president when he was running for office. So, and they think that's what, helped put him over the edge. So this is actually a very interesting thing to consider all of a sudden, because we're so focused on thinking of that presidential connection that we forget. It's like who's on your bench is almost just as important for your fantasy football team or your fantasy basketball team as who your starting five is, right? You got to consider if you're looking to influence politics, spread UBI for lack of a better term, how you get the furthest, the fastest, and who knows, maybe that is a VP slot. Keep going.
That is a great point. We'll go through the article a little bit here, but the funny thing is, it's just kind of a slightly different take or a slightly different angle. A lot of the takes we've had, for example, I'm going to flash over a great part of the article I talk about here where they say, Yang's message appeals to all types of voters, many of whom are part of his diehard online base of supporters, which is, we can go through and look up hours of videos of us talking exactly about that, where the Yang Gang encompasses, like, former Republicans, former Democrats who left the party and came back, former voters who weren't voting, people who were diehard Trump voters, people who were diehard Hillary voters. Like, it's pulling all kinds of people to this party.
Lesbians for Yang with
exactly.
Heidi Briones.
But when you think about it, where does that actually help and where does that mean a lot if he does not win the nomination? Which, by the way, I still think this election's so weird, he's actually primed. If there ever were to be someone to come around and shock the world in an election, it'd be Yang in 2020.
Yeah.
But that aside, holy cow, when he make a strong VP? I mean, think about it for a lot of these candidates. Think about Joe Biden. What is Joe Biden really lacking? It's like, well, does Joe Biden really have any things he talks about? Does Joe Biden really have any, like does he understand, like, the internet and how young people, like the next generation of, not generation of, like, high school kids, but the next generation of, adult voters in the 30s to 40s, what's going to matter to them? Is he that out of touch? Yang addresses that and shores that up, right? Any candidate where it's kind of like, yeah, but their policies, what do they really stand for? They just say, hey, I'm bringing on Andrew Yang, and I think he has a lot of great ideas. I'm going to adopt a few of them, and you get to just pick or choose the ones your base likes. I mean, he could really be the VP candidate to take a candidate. I mean, it's a lot of people say Yang beats Trump and that Yang does well against Trump head-to-head. But, I mean, I'm just looking at the top people right now. I do not see Sanders or Warren taking Yang on. But the man who returned to the front of the pack, the front runner, is Joe Biden again. I mean, I don't know about you, but like I said, not only do I think Yang could be a very strong VP, I think if he were to be a VP, Biden would be the guy. And right now, Biden's still in front. I don't know. I don't know what you think about that. First of all, do you think he would be a strong VP? And then two, who do you think he actually would realistically be the VP of?
I think that Joe Biden is going to hemorrhage more votes, but is still so large that even if you take a big chunk out of him, you know what I'm saying, he'll still be one of the heavyweight contenders. And he'll have a big question. He'll have a big question on his mind. How do I make it in this race past the finish line, still highest in the polls, so I have the best chance of becoming the nominee? And as the field narrows, okay, and you start running out of options, choosing a running mate to boost your appeal. Yeah, I mean, it worked for Ted Cruz when he chose Carly Fiorina. You know what I'm saying? It didn't take him all the way, but it gave him a boost, an extra 2 weeks of relevance in the news cycle. You know what I'm saying? However, Andrew Yang would bring to Joe Biden a lot more than Carly Fiorina brought to Ted Cruz, as evidenced by what it actually points out in the article. And I'd like to bring up these points. That it says he's making waves. That's point number one. It's true. So he's getting press. And while he might seem like an unconventional statistic, that net 22 is higher than a lot of the other candidates. And he has the highest net support of all the 2020 Democratic candidates among undecided general election voters. And I think Joe Biden is smart enough to know that I can't just have some SJW attached to my hip with all of this corporate baggage and high donor baggage like Warren has, without this Pocahontas baggage like Warren has, or with, you know, the Bernie Sanders baggage. Like, I need somebody that's going to not weigh me down, but boost me up. And that's where the Yang Gang comes in. I don't know why this isn't the first bullet point, but actually is the last bullet point in the article. Says Yang also has a highly loyal and active base of digital supporters. The antithesis of Joe Biden. Joe Biden's like the boomer king. You know what I'm saying? And then now you also got the young crowd king. So Yang has a highly active base of digital supporters, the Yang Gang, an extremely valuable asset in modern politics. True, that few politicians can claim to have. I think only one can. You can't name another group except for maybe the residual youthful vigor that still hung on to Bernie Sanders, but you can't name one candidate that has a gang, a digital gang, like the Yang Gang. Only Andrew Yang does. And that one would bring him, and one that Yang would bring with him to presidential ticket. I mean, I doubt the Yang Gang is going to say, okay, we're packing up our bags and going home just because he's the VP. You know, those of us that are enthusiastic about UBI, or the people that are enthusiastic about Yang, or X, Y, or Z enthusiasm marker will still be there, and people will want to push for him, which is nothing he would get from anybody else. So I don't think Joe Biden could make it by himself, but if he got an extra 20-point boost, an extra 10-point boost from these little nitroglycerin packs, you know what I'm saying, that you save in the racing game until you're close to the finish and you release them so you beat your opponents. Did you like that video game reference, Doc?
Very good, man.
That was a good one, you know? Andrew Yang might be those nitro packs, man. And I would be looking at that very seriously if I were a campaign manager for Joe Biden. And it's interesting to see that now there is a statistic, a 22 net percentage points, you know what I'm saying, in popularity, that is a measurable quantifier showing how he is that popular. Also, speaking of not having baggage, it points out that while Yang is running as a Democrat, having never held political office or being formally attached to a political party has given him remarkable latitude to carve out his own distinct political brand. Basically, he doesn't have 8 years worth of NRA rating saying whether or not he's pro or anti-gun. He doesn't have 8 years of Planned Parenthood's watchdog group saying whether he's for or against their pet projects. Okay, he's kind of a clean slate. And with that, you don't have any kind of baggage, for lack of a better term. No skeletons in your closet. So I don't know. I think this is a really interesting article, something to consider. And I like seeing the math associated with this claim.
Well, but here's the other thing, too. It's not just this one article.
Okay. I want to show, man, you got more that you didn't tell me about?
Sort of. I want to show some evidence, first of all. So, first of all, I want to highlight one thing. The I guess we'll call it the evolution of Andrew Yang's stance on Joe Biden. We have an article here. It's not an article. It's just talking about an appearance he had on MSNBC dating back to, I believe, September of this year. Andrew Yang says Joe Biden would send country literally backwards by restoring the Obama presidency. Okay. He goes on in the interview to say,
is that just them misinterpreting? Because I don't trust NBC, even with people I hate.
If you well, this is a Newsweek article about the appearance.
Okay.
That we're doing a YouTube video about. Okay. Go figure. Anyway, if you listen to Joe talk about it, his main argument is that his election is going to be a restoration of Obama Biden. In essence, Yang said, which is a move literally backwards in time. And so to me, saying that we can somehow erase not just Donald Trump's presidency, but all of the reasons why people voted for Donald Trump, to me, is not correct. So that was what Yang was saying about Joe Biden, who he's running against.
Yeah, that didn't seem like an attack. That just seems like saying we need to move forward, not backwards.
No, exactly. It wasn't awful. I'm just saying he wasn't. However, now we have an article, and this is another funny kind of little, Washington Times. So Andrew Yang teases running in 2020 with Joe Biden.
But then you all read it in Newsweek, and then you knew it was true. Sorry, Dave Chappelle quotes. Anyway, keep going.
No, but Andrew Yang teases running. I mean, all he says here, he literally teases running it. They ask him and they say, where's the quote? What question? They say, would you be willing to potentially run on the same ticket? Wow, that's a big endorsement. And he said, I'm definitely open to working with Joe. We've actually talked about it.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
The weird thing. Is I remember that. We've actually talked about it a little bit. At the same time, I don't have an article put up for this, but you can look it up. Multiple times, Joe Biden has actually, early on in the process, especially when Andrew Yang was a much smaller name, Biden would like go out of his way to pull him aside and say, hey, the stuff you're talking about, fourth industrial revolution, jobs, all this stuff you're talking about, I think you're, this is really passionate. I think you're right on. I want to talk to you about this. Yang's even joked a couple times. Like the first few times, I thought he was just like, what do I say to this Yang guy? Automation. But then he's like, now it's like, he really is serious about this. He's even, Joe Biden said fourth industrial revolution on stage of the debate now after Yang popularized it. So there is some, there's a little bit of a connection between these two. We've just went through and did the math, so to speak. But again, you look at who's running and who's realistically, if it's not, if Yang doesn't win, he doesn't win the primary, realistically, is he going to be Bernie Sanders' running mate? No, they're so diametrically opposed, and so like they literally have like inverse policies of each other and multiple things, and they just they insist mine will work and yours won't. I don't see why they'd be VP. I do not see Warren Yang, Biden Yang would be the one. Again, I still think Yang works better as a president than a VP, because while he does bring that audience with you, I do think he works better being the president with a very good, respected, in the know, DC type Democrat as his VP. I think that makes more sense to me. I think we've had it happen, not just Trump. Remember, Trump wasn't the first. We've had people that even Obama, he was a junior senator for like a term or two. Like it wasn't like Obama was this big time established. We've seen people come in as non-establishment types and, you know, run a White House. So I think Yang can do that, but it's really fascinating. Like you said, you know, first of all, Yang kind of not looking at it, but saying, look, we've talked with Joe Biden about it. And then, like you said, we have this piece here from Business Insider saying, is Andrew Yang the ideal running mate? Once it shows he could be the ideal running mate. And I think if you're talking about ideal running mate for Joe Biden, he might be the ideal running mate. I don't know if there's a better running mate for Joe Biden. They're really, I mean, I really am trying to think. The only thing we would say, and we talked about
except
this earlier,
for our boy John Delaney.
Oh, yeah, my boy Delaney.
No.
But aside from that, the one downside I would say, and we talked about this a little bit earlier today even, was that Yang does struggle a little bit in progressive crowds, and it's not exactly like the progressive audience is where we're seeing Biden killing it either. That is the one thing I would say, but I don't know, man. Is it? Could it be? Could we see? And let us know in the comments if you guys would even support that or if you'd be happy if you did that. Like, for example, this Yang gang that article just kind of takes for granted and assumes would throw their support behind any candidate. Let us know in the comments. If, for whatever reason, Warren tabbed Yang to be her VP and he ran as her VP, would you support Elizabeth Warren? I think that's a really kind of a interesting question. And even more interesting, if Biden does just hold this lead and win the thing and he picks Yang as his VP, what would the Yang gang do? Would they, as the article suggests, just kind of fall in line and say, well, our boy Yang's going to the White House one way or another? Or would it be like, well, I don't know. Personally, I think...
Hey, that's not what we bargained for.
I don't think fall in line is the right term, but I definitely think, you know, getting Yang in the White House the better way to move forward and legitimize his ideas than not being in the White House despite Joe Biden would be overall. I mean, I think a better way to legitimize UBI is to get it in the White House than it is to have him, in spite, refuse an opportunity. Because, dude, if Biden does, for whatever reason, just hold this primary, and, like, that's the Biden VP spot's not a bad spot to get. So that's really fascinating. Again, I still not only would rather see Yang serve as president, I think he makes more sense as president than VP, but very interesting angle. Anything else you want to say? Just very fascinating angle, man. I had thought about it a little bit, but I hadn't kind of put it all together like that until now. And that's really interesting, man. Really interesting.
Yeah, I think the true test, just like my father said, things are only worth what people are going to pay for them. I think the true test is to see what the other politically savvy candidates on the field, how they treat him. It's kind of like at the end of that movie, Bridge of Spies.
Oh, I haven't seen it. Heard it was really good.
Oh, you haven't? Yeah, it was great. They're returning in the hostage exchange. And then the Americans come up and they hug their fellow Americans, say, oh, you're back, yada, yada, this and that. And then the guy that's getting returned to the Russians says, I will know whether or not I'm going to live or I'm going to die by how they respond to me coming back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so I think the way that they respond to Andrew Yang, I think, is really going to be the ultimate test. The bridge of spies test, if you will. Bridge so anyway, let us know what you guys think in the comment below. How would the Yang gang respond to a Biden Yang as VP ticket, or really in anything and Yang as VP ticket? Would it take some wind out of your sails? Would it still excite you that much more? Let us know. If you haven't had a chance to like the video yet, please like. If you want to contribute to the channel, there's a PayPal link in the description, or you can just give us a sub on Twitch. No matter what, make sure you hang out with us on Tuesdays and Thursdays, or give us a voicemail at 1-833-PSP-RADIO. This is Problem Solver Politics. We'll see you guys in the next video.